Whole genome sequencing is a powerful technology that is rapidly gaining popularity as it becomes more and more affordable. With whole genome sequencing, you can assemble genomes de novo, compare the genome of your organism to a reference genome, explore the molecular evolution of a species or population, accurately track pathogen outbreaks, obtain the whole genome sequence of an individual cell, and so much more. Whole genome sequencing begins with the extraction of genomic DNA. This is typically done with a kit relevant to a specific sample type, for example, blood or plant tissue. The genomic DNA is made into libraries, which are quality checked, pooled, and normalized. They are then sequenced using an Illumina NGS platform, such as NextSeq. The amount of coverage and the number of reads needed will depend on the type of genome and the application chosen. For a more detailed description of library prep, quality control, and coverage, please see our previous videos. Now let's talk about some real examples of whole genome sequencing applications. Whole genome sequencing can be used to assemble genomes de novo. Recently, an international collaboration achieved this for the genome of the flax plant and published in the Plant Journal in 2012. Flax is an important crop both for food and textile production. The flax genome was assembled using a short shotgun sequencing approach. The authors generated 7 libraries, with lengths varying from 300 base pairs up to 10 kilobase pairs, and sequenced them using paired-end Illumina. This generated mate pair and paired-end reads with 44 to 100 base pairs of known sequence and a spacer of defined length. The use of mate pairs from long libraries replaces the conventional approach for correlating sequences long range. In the conventional method, phosmid libraries are prepared in parallel to the NGS libraries and are sequenced using Sanger sequencing. This is more expensive and time-consuming than the new NGS-only approach shown here. Aligning these reads generated contigs. The contigs were further aligned to generate scaffolds. The scaffolds covered 85% of the predicted genome length, with 45 times average coverage. For more details on how the genome was assembled, please refer to the original publication. Expressed sequence tags, or ESTs, are short sequences obtained from cDNA libraries. They represent expressed regions of the genome and so can be used to find protein-coding genes. In this study, the known ESTs of flax were aligned to the scaffolds. 93% of them aligned to the scaffolds with greater than 95% sequence identity, indicating that the assembled genes were highly accurate. For more information about the study, please refer to the original publication. Whole genome sequencing can also be used to track pathogen outbreaks. This proof-of-concept study by Revez et al. Does just that. Campylobacter jejuni is among the leading causes of foodborne illness in the world. It is naturally found in the guts of birds and cows. Humans are most likely to become infected by ingesting contaminated water. C. jejuni infection is debilitating, but rarely fatal. In this study, samples from a C. jejuni outbreak in Europe in 2012 were reanalyzed by whole genome sequencing and compared to the conclusions drawn from standard methodologies. This was done in order to decide if whole genome sequencing had similar or enhanced ability to track pathogen source and evolution during an outbreak situation. The gold standard for analyzing strains of pathogenic bacteria is called pulsed field gel electrophoresis, PFGE, which compares the banding pattern between genomes digested by a restriction enzyme. This approach is limited, however, since significant mutations can easily be hidden when they don't affect the restriction sites or relative size of the genomic fragments. At the same time, single nucleotide mutations can result in the gain or loss of a restriction site and so can give a different PFGE pattern between closely related strains. Based on the PFGE patterns observed during the outbreak, it was concluded that there was a contamination event involving one strain and one water source. However, whole genome sequencing revealed that this was not the case. Of the two human isolates shown here, One was found to be highly similar to the waterborne strain, the other is highly divergent, too much so to be the result of genetic drift during the course of the outbreak. In light of the whole genome sequencing data, the authors conclude that either a single source of water was contaminated by multiple divergent strains, or that there were multiple sources of contamination. These results highlight the importance of more accurate whole genome sequencing data during pathogen outbreaks, since conventional methodology misidentified a patient's strain, potentially missing an important source of contamination. Whole genome sequencing is also an essential tool for studying molecular evolution. This study, in Nature Communications in 2015, uses whole genome sequencing to study the molecular evolution of the Ithaca, New York honeybee population in response to the introduction of the mite Varroa destructor. Honeybees, Apis mellifera, are essential to human agriculture. Both feral and domestic populations exist in North America. Honeybees are a eusocial species. Each colony contains a sexually mature queen bee, a few thousand haploid males, and tens of thousands of sterile female worker bees. The mite Varroa destructor feeds on the hemolymph of the adult worker bees, weakening them and making them more susceptible to disease. The authors found a drastic loss of mitochondrial haplotypes, with an entire clade going extinct. This loss indicates a population bottleneck upon the introduction of Varroa destructor. However, they also found no decrease in nuclear genetic diversity. This finding indicates that the modern population is descended from a small number of queens through high rates of outbreeding and polyandry. The ancestry of the modern bee population is similar to the museum bees, with a few variations. In the modern bees, there are traces of African and Arabian ancestry that are absent in the museum bees. The authors also found some genes that were under selection pressure in the modern population relative to the museum bees. These genes may play a role in resistance to the Varroa destructor parasite. For more details, please see the original paper. This study demonstrates how whole genome sequencing is a powerful tool for studying the molecular evolution of a population over time. This has been just a few applications of whole genome sequencing. Thank you for watching. Look forward to our next video coming soon, and don't forget to leave your questions and comments below.